So in this video, let's cover group by function in Excel. It's a new function, and if you're familiar with pivot tables, you can just think about this function as creating a pivot table without using columns section. Now, there's also a function called pivot by, which allows you to also do something where you would use columns section, but that's going to be a separate video. So let's just talk about group by and how it works. So I'm going to go equals group by, and you're going to see we have row fields. So this will be your group column in your pivot table, or you can just think about this as the column with no function. And for that, let's say I'm going to select this list of regions. And in this case, as you can see, I'm not including the header on top. And I'll talk about that because you can also include the header depending on what you want. Now I'm going to go comma, and the second part here is values. So this will be the column with a function. So for example, if you want to get total sales or average sales or count of sales or whatever other function you may want to apply to sales column, that means in that case, sales is my values field. So I'm going to go ahead and select this. Comma, and then finally, the third required argument here is going to be the function that we want to apply to that value field. So in this case, sales is the value field, and assuming I just want to sum them, the function would be sum. Now, the function you have to basically enter without execution. So what I mean by that is you are probably used to when you have a function is to run the function with opening and closing parentheses like this. But here, we're not going to execute the function. So it's just going to be the function sum without opening and closing parentheses. I'm going to close parentheses for this group by function. And if I enter, see, we'll get our total sales for each region. And then down here, we get the total, similar to how you get that in a pivot table. Now, if I go back to this formula, the next argument here we have that's optional, if I do comma, it's going to be field headers. And you can see there are a few different options here, like no, yes, but don't show, no, but generate, and yes, and show, right? So this is where it matters when you select this data, if you include the header or not. So in this case, if you look at my example, I didn't include this headers region and sales. So therefore, I could use no, saying that I don't have a header, or I could say, go back here and say no, but generate. And if I'd enter, see now it will put this label on top, row field and value one. So it generates these names because it couldn't grab those names from the data. Now I could also, instead of doing this, go back to this. And when I'm selecting these two ranges, I can actually include the header. So I'm going to select this, comma, and then values like this. And now I do include headers. So therefore, as this argument for field headers, I can say yes, but don't show, meaning we do have headers on top here, but we don't want to have that in our results, basically. And that would essentially just get us the same thing. Or I could go back here and switch this to yes and show. And this way, I'm saying that the first row is headers and let's display those in our results. So you can see region sales is going to be picked up from here. So you can do whichever way you want to go here. I'm going to go back and just not include that first row in this whole thing. And I'm just going to say no. And then finally, by default, you can see how it also includes the line of your grand total. And you can also choose to not display the grand total. So we can go back here and do a comma. And here we can say, basically, you can see we have grand totals, we have grand totals and subtotals, and we'll talk about the subtotal situation. But right now, I can say just no totals like this. And this way, we'll get the same results, but no headers on top and no totals below. So you can decide which way you want to go, and that's the way you're going to choose to do this. And of course, you can use other functions. So instead of summing these, I can switch this to average, hit enter, and now we get the average per region. You can do pretty much any aggregate function here, and we'll talk about a few non-standard examples. But for example, we could do something like standard deviation. And that would give us that. Now you can also do custom things, and we'll talk about that, and that gets really interesting here. But before I get to that, I also want to talk about one more thing, is that these row fields and value fields, they also support multiple columns. So right now I chose one column for row fields and one column for value fields. Now we can also, instead of choosing a single column, we can choose two columns for row fields, and also values can support multiple columns too. But right now I'm just gonna keep just a single column. I'll do the sales amounts. And once again, let's just choose sum for a function, close parentheses, hit enter, and that gives us, as you can see, sum by region by rep. So basically, now because I chose two row fields, it's gonna go find all the possible Midwest and sales rep combinations. So here we have Midwest Isabella, then Midwest Jennifer, then Midwest Jake. So all of those and the total for each one of those. And then the next region, and so it goes. And then you can see all the way down here, we have our grand total. Now, if you look at these examples, you're gonna see that there's no subtotals. So for example, when we get Midwest totals, then there's no total for Midwest here. Now you can get those, if you remember we had that section, if I do comma here, and I'm gonna say there are no headers because I didn't include the first row here, comma. And then here for totals, well, again, I can say no totals to not have totals at all, like maybe you don't want this grand total here. Or you can say, I wanna have grand totals and subtotals like this. And if I enter, now you can see, not only do we get this Midwest different rep totals, but then we get this subtotal for this Midwest section. And then the same thing is gonna happen for the next region and the next region after that. And then finally, we have a grand total too. So you can choose whether you want to have those totals or not, depending on what it is you're after. Finally, what's also cool here, you can also filter your results. So if you wanted to get these totals, let's say for a certain category or for a certain region or something like that, you can do a comma here. Well, here is the sort order, how you want this result sorted. I'm gonna skip that, but you can use that too. So you can do positive or negative here to get your ascending or descending. So I'm gonna go comma, I'm gonna skip that. And the next one is this filter array. And this will be basically a dynamic array of trues and falses, which you can generate any way you want. So this is a separate topic. If you want to look at arrays and getting trues and falses, you should really look into it a lot more in depth. But here, just to give you a basic example, I could just grab this category column and check if it equals dress. And this will create that true and false array. And whatever's true is gonna stay, whatever is false is gonna get removed. And if I enter, see, now we get basically our totals for dress category, and we get our totals for each region rep, and then our subtotal, and then our grand total. And of course, if you don't wanna have those grand totals and subtotals, you can always go here and say no totals. And there it is. So, if you're a Google Sheets user, this is very similar to your query function in many ways. So you can still apply your filters, you can apply different aggregate functions, but here you're more flexible in what functions you can apply. So for example, if you're using something like a query function in Google Sheets, there's very limited aggregate functions you can apply, but here you have pretty much the entire function list in Excel in your disposal. So let me give you an example of using more than one function. Now for that, let me just simplify this. So I'll just go back to just selecting the list of regions, and I'll grab this list of value fields. For this will be sales, comma, and for function, I'm gonna start with sum. So right now it's gonna sum our total for each region, and you can see we get our totals. Now let's assume a situation where some of these numbers are text instead of a number, and we would like to handle that. So for example, see here, this Midwest, here I have like 6,000. I'm gonna add an apostrophe to make it text. And as I add this apostrophe for Midwest, you'll see this number will decrease because sum by default ignores text. So I'll go here and I'm gonna add maybe another apostrophe here. And you can see that Midwest total is going to decrease. Now, I wanna make sure I handle that and convert these numbers to an actual number so it can actually do math with these numbers. And the function to that would be value function. So value function is going to convert this to a number from text. So that being said, now we have a problem because we have to take the value function first to convert it to a number and then sum it all up. And here, if we go back, now we have this problem. Okay, so how do we do that then? How do we do sum and then put value inside of this sum? Because remember, this should be a function with no execution. And if I open parentheses, now I'm gonna have a function with execution. And this is where lambda function comes into play. So lambda function, I have separate videos about this function. Super complicated. You should really watch a separate video just about lambda to truly understand how it works. But basically the idea of lambda function, it's a function that creates a function that's not executed. And that is going to allow us to basically now use different functions here. So with lambda function, we're gonna accept a parameter, which is gonna be basically each line in that values column. So I'll just call that parameter x. Could be any variable, but I'm gonna go with x, comma. And then we have the calculation we want to do with this parameter. And with this, I can say, well, we want to value and sum that x. So I'll close parentheses for value and for sum, and then for lambda, like this. And this will create a new lambda function that will take each row, run value function, and then run sum function and get you the result. And because lambda doesn't do any executions, it's just a function with no execution, then that's exactly what we need. Our group by function will do that execution for us for each row. So now if I hit enter, you'll notice that it will grab those numbers that are not numbers, convert them to a number with value function, and then sum it, and our totals actually work. So that's one example you can see where I can use lambda function with other Excel functions. And you can see the possibilities here are endless, right? So we can use the entire list of functions in Excel to do something with each row and generate some results. Let me give you another example. So I'm gonna get rid of this. And I'll do another group by, and this time I'm gonna use non-conventional value field. And what I mean by that is, let's say we have this group of salespeople, and I wanna see which regions they have sales in. So I'm gonna go comma, and for value field, I'm gonna use this region column. Now, with region column, we need to do a function. So we need to somehow, it's text. Now with text, I could count it, but I don't want to count it. I want to list the regions. Now, I could just use something like concat, right? So if I do concat, it will concatenate. It's a text function. And if I close parentheses, hit enter, you're going to see it will basically take all the regions for grace and it will just join them together. But the problem with this, there's no comma it looks weird. And then also, if we have repeats, like over here, it will basically repeat that region like tons of times in this. So it doesn't look good. Now I'm gonna go back here. And instead of concat, I'm going to do another lambda here to create a new function. And once again, I'm gonna accept that x as a parameter, or you can use anything else instead of x, but here x is gonna be my parameter. And then what I'll do, I'll run this function called textJoin. And textJoin, basically, it's still similar to concat, but it allows you to do some sort of separator in between those instead of just putting right next to each other. So we can do a space, we can do a comma. I'm just gonna go with a comma as a delimiter, comma, ignore empty cells. I'm gonna say true, comma, and then I'm gonna take that x parameter, I'm gonna put it right there, x, and then close parentheses, and then another close parentheses for my lambda function, and then we have group by. So I'm gonna hit enter so you can see what happens. So basically this is gonna generate the same results as concat, but it's just gonna add commas. So if I hit enter, see, we get the same results, but now we have basically commas separating these different regions. But what it's not gonna do is take care of duplicate situations like this. So I would like to also remove duplicates. And to do that, I'm gonna go back to my formula. And before I join here, I'm gonna take that x and run it through unique function. Like this, and like this. So we'll take that value field, which is gonna be a bunch of text. We'll run unique to get a unique list, and then we'll join it with a comma. So if I enter, see, we get the same results, but we don't get any duplicates. So it's just a unique list for each one. So we get, see, Grace, Isabella, Jake, so we know Jennifer, for example, had sales in these two regions, John in this region, and so it goes. So there you go. That's your introduction to group by function. So basically think about it as a very powerful way to create something similar to a pivot table with a formula instead of using a pivot table. And of course, because it's a formula, anytime you make any change, it's gonna automatically update. So if I go here and change, for example, this Grace to Anna, you'll see it's gonna give us a new list. We have now Anna in the list. Let me know if you have any questions about this formula. There's really a lot more to cover here, but that should give you the gist of how this works. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.